Good morning, Bill Risser with Chicago Title. Our last video, we talked about what has to happen before the buyer can come in to sign. Today, I want to dig a little deeper into the actual preparation of the pre-audit. When loan documents arrive, the escrow officer's first task is to review those lender's instructions carefully. For some lenders, it's 2 or 3 pages. For some, it's 20. But it's important for us to understand exactly how that lender wants us to handle this transaction, or we've got big problems down the road. A lender can come back to us under the ALTA policy and file a claim if we do not follow their instructions to the letter. So that's very important, and that's the first part of the process. Secondly, the escrow officer will then take the contract and the lender's instructions and begin, you know, putting the fees onto the settlement statement in the appropriate spaces. With the new RESPA regulations and the new HUD-1, this has become a little more uniform, especially with FHA. We've got some nice features, the ability to lump sum all the seller credit for the buyer. Previously on FHA loans, we had to actually shift fees from the buyer to the seller to equal the total amount of credits. That's gone away for the most part. We still have a lender or two that wants to see the fees move, even though it's not really a requirement for the HUD-1 anymore. But these are all part of the things that an escrow officer goes through as they're trying to get this settlement statement prepared. So once the settlement statement or the pre-audit is ready, it's then loaded into our online system and distributed to everyone in the transaction. By everyone, I mean the lender and both real estate agents. At this point, we need them to review the settlement statement and give us their approval to move forward. This is important. We want the lender, of course, has to approve it before we can bring in the buyer. They want to make sure that everything is set exactly per their instructions. And for real estate agents, it's very important for them to go through that settlement statement and make sure that everything they asked for or detailed out in the contract is applied correctly on the settlement statement. It's important. It's part of your job as an agent to make sure that your client's being taken care of. So if you have any questions, please leave a comment below, or you can always email me at billrisser@gmail.com. Go out and make it a great day.